there are different types of spiders. Not all spiders make webs. So jumping spiders jump directly to the prey. Biological studies has revealed that jumping spiders have very unique and specialized optics. So instead of a single layer retina, as in human beings, they have multiple semi-transparent retina. They can capture multiple images of the same scene, but the images captured on different layers of retina have different level of blurriness. People suspect that they're able to extract the depth information in a very efficient way, considering the size of their brain. This inspired us that maybe this method of taking multiple images and comparing the blurriness would be a good strategy to build a depth sensor. It combines a multifunctional flat lens with very efficient computer vision algorithm.
So we really believe that optics and algorithms should be designed together with a joint collaboration with applied physicists, for example, here at Harvard.
In this project, we collaborate with computer scientists and took inspiration from biologists and bring everything together to build this very efficient snapshot depth sensor.
I mainly see two major applications for this depth sensor. One is the microrobots. You can see that Harvard already has a lot of applications for such kind of robots. For example, the robot bees and robot swarms. If you want to have navigations or local motions for those kind of robots, you must have depth sensing on them. So the second part is the augmented reality and the virtual reality, as well as other wearable devices.
After billions of years of evolution, nature has delivered diverse solutions to almost everything. Why don't we just take this and transfer to artificial systems instead of coming up with new designs that are probably worse than what nature has provided?